Good afternoon and welcome to the Countdown studio. Now, I don't know whether you read the same article that I read the other day about predators. And apparently one of the world's most voracious predators is none other than our eight-legged friend, the spider. Now, the amazing thing is, and I think somebody's got the decimal point in the wrong place, it says here, spiders eat up to 800 million tonnes of prey a year. So I think this is extraordinary. Now, I know that a lot of people are, you know, fearful of arachnids, and therefore they're arachnophobes, I guess. My granddaughter is not one of those.
Good.
I might tell you that at her fourth birthday party, with all her little friends turned up in little floral pink printed dresses, my daughter, feeling that children should sort of handle animals and understand these things, brought in a chap who had a lot of snakes with him, and also a tarantula, which she was very happy to have on her face.
Yeah, I've done that.
Have you done that?
Yeah, I've had one on my face.
Oh.
I mean, if you say, this is Sharon, she's fine, here you go, have a hold, that's fine. But if I saw one, I saw an April Fool's prank where someone drew a massive spider on the loo roll so that when his wife wound it down, there's this massive spider. And when you're not expecting it, I think I probably have a different reaction.
What a good trick.
Mm.
That's a prank. Well done. Now, who have we got? We've got two new contestants, as you know, Rachel. We've got Luke Parker, a health food store supervisor from Leek in Staffordshire, big football fan. And the health food business, is that continuing to boom as we all try and improve our diet?
It is, yeah, especially like turmeric. I say, with all the new research that's come out.
OK.
It's massive.
Excellent stuff. Well, good luck to you today. You're joined by Laura Marsh, a digital insight analyst from Rorton. So, you're a Rorton girl?
Yes.
Yeah,
so,
I remember.
Yeah, it's a lovely village. It's kind of just tagged on to the, just to Swindon, sort of on, safely on the other side of the motorway there. But
that's
it is,
right.
It's a really lovely village with great community.
Up the hill. I know, because I was at the kindergarten there, probably about 67 years ago, and yet it's as fresh today as it was then.
Brilliant.
So that's Rorton. That's my memory of Rorton.
It's lovely.
Good luck to you both, Laura and Luke. Big round of applause. And over in the corner, Susie, of course, and with more historical tales to tell, Susanna Lipscomb. Welcome back, Susanna.
Thank you.
Welcome back. Now then, Luke, off we go. Letters game.
Can I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thank you, Luke. Start today with S.
And a vowel, please.
U.
And a consonant.
M.
And a vowel, please.
O.
And another.
E.
And a consonant.
B.
And another.
S.
And another.
N.
And a final vowel, please.
And a final I.
And here's the countdown clock. Yes, Luke.
Five.
A five, Laura.
Six.
Yes, Luke.
Sumos.
Sumos, indeed, Laura.
Bosom.
Ah, bosom.
Okay, how are you spelling bosom?
B-U-S-S-O-M.
B-U-S-S-O-M. Okay, so bosom. No, bosom is B-O-S-O-M. Oh. And there's no bosom, unfortunately, in there. And how are you spelling sumo?
Sumo with an S at the end.
OK, fine, not with E.
Yeah.
That's absolutely fine. Yeah.
Well done. All right, so, Susanna and Susie,
we've
what
got
news?
Nimbuses.
Nimbuses, yes.
Yes, luminous clouds. There's lovely nimbus clouds. Plural is nimbi or nimbuses.
Nimbuses. Okay. All right, thank you. Now we turn to Laura. Laura, letters game.
Hiya. Hi, Laura. May I have a consonant, please?
You may, thank you. Start with T.
Another one, please.
P.
And another.
T.
A vowel, please.
A.
And another?
E.
Another?
I.
A consonant, please.
R.
Another, please.
D.
And one more.
And lastly, Y.
Stand by. Laura?
Six.
A six and?
And a five.
And your five?
Taped.
Now, Laura?
Patter.
Yep, absolutely fine.
It's patter. And Susanna? Susie?
Dietary for seven.
Yes.
Have you had another seven?
And pirated as well for seven.
Pirated, yeah. Pirated indeed. So it's Laura on six, Luke on at five, and it's Luke's numbers game now. Luke?
Two from the top and the rest small.
Four little ones.
Yeah, yeah.
Thanks,
cheers.
Luke. Two big, four little. For the first time today, they are six, five, three, another five, and then the big ones, 125. And the target,
936.
936. Yes, Luke?
935.
One away. How about Laura?
931.
931. Let's turn to Luke then, shall we first?
Yeah, it's 6 plus 3 equals 9. Times by 100.
900.
Plus 25.
95.
And then 5 plus 5 and then add that.
935, one away.
Well done. But 936, Rachel, help us.
With this one, you could have said 25 minus 5 is 20. Divided by the other five is four. Add to the 100 for 100 and four. And then six plus three is nine and times them together.
There we go. 936. Well done. As we turn to our first tea time teaser, which is isn't crime. And the clue, it isn't a crime, it's just wholesale stupidity. It isn't a crime, it's just wholesale stupidity. Welcome back. I left with the clue, it isn't a crime, it's just wholesale stupidity. And the answer to that is cretinism. From cretin, I guess.
Yeah, well, once a medical condition, it was congenital thyroid deficiency that caused physical malformations. And cretin goes back to the French chrétien, meaning Christian, because they wanted to show that these people were human beings and not beasts. So it's actually quite a kind
it
word
is.
To begin with. Yeah.
12 plays 6, Luke on 12, and it's Laura's letters game.
Okie dokes. May I have a consonant, please?
You may, thank you, Laura. N.
Another?
D.
A vowel?
O.
Another?
A.
Another consonant?
R.
Another consonant?
M.
Another vowel?
U.
Another vowel.
I.
And one more consonant, please.
And lastly, S.
Stand by. Luke?
5.
And that 5?
Rains.
Laura?
Drains.
Happy enough?
Drains, yeah, absolutely.
Now, Suzanne's nodding.
We had an 8.
Yippee.
Dinosaur.
Oh, perfect. A dinosaur. Well done. Well done. So 12 apiece here, and it's Luke's letters game. Luke?
Can I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, Luke. N.
And a vowel?
E.
And another?
A.
And another?
O.
And a consonant?
W.
And another?
P.
And another?
M.
And another?
S.
And a final vowel, please.
And a final U.
Countdown. Yes, Luke?
5.
And Laura?
6.
And a 6. Luke?
Pawns.
Now, Laura?
I've just used the N twice, I think. Sorry.
That's a withdrawal.
It is. Right. I messed up.
And in the corner?
We have weapons for 7.
Very good. Weapons.
And a wonderful dessert called Spumoni. Which you can spell with the I at the end, but also E in this case. It's a kind of ice cream dessert with different colours and flavours in layers, so perhaps a bit like a Knickerbocker glory.
Indeed. Thank you, Spumoni. And it's 17 to 12. Luke back in the lead. Laura, your numbers game now.
I may I have 2 from the top and any other 5, please.
I'll give you 4.
4 even.
How about that?
Something we'll
do
like
a deal. Thank you, Laura. The 4 little ones. 7, 9... 6 and 10, and the big 2, 50 and 75. And this target to reach 307.
307. Laura?
307.
And Luke?
307.
Thank you. So, Laura?
So, 50 times 6?
300.
Plus the 7.
Yeah, we could do that in our heads.
And
the same way,
same
yeah.
way, just for, you know, good form. Happy enough? All right. So, still that 5-point difference, 27 to 22, as we turn to Susanna. Susanna, it's very easy just to look back on various events in history and say to ourselves, what a stupid decision that was.
Well, yes, there are instances where we think they made a great mistake. So, in the case of the plague in 1665, the Lord Chamberlain of the city ordered 40,000 dogs and 200,000 cats to be killed because they were thought to be spreading the plague. And, of course, the irony is that he was therefore destroying the predators, to bring you back to your earlier word, of the flea-carrying rats that were actually spreading the plague. Mistake because they just didn't know what caused it. They knew that the plague was horrible, that it killed horribly quickly. In 1 month alone, September 1665, it had killed 30,000 people in London, but they didn't know what was causing it. Pamphlets of the time talk about profanity or drunkenness or gluttony being the cause. And medical officials thought this as well, so the College of Physicians in 1536 talked about there being an epidemic of wood lice just before the plague, and maybe that was the cause. Mm. And actually, there's something about spiders as well. There was a report to the Royal Society saying that just before the plague in Danzig, there'd been a large number of spiders, so that must be it. And perhaps my favourite example is the fact they thought tobacco was so effective as a preventative that one boy in Eton was thrashed for not smoking his pipe because you know, he wasn't holding off the plague. So many of the things that we think about as mistakes actually were, of course, them just not having the knowledge. And it was something they were terrified of because it occurred, on average in Europe, it occurred once every 9 years in the early modern period. So that means that everybody saw a devastating plague at some point in their lives, if not several times, and lost people to it. Terrible. So you can imagine it would have been awful.
I mean, the great plague, didn't it sort of halve the population of Europe or something?
The Black Death, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, it was the vast numbers in 3 years or so in the 14th century. It more than decimated, if that is the correct use of that word, the population of Europe.
Amazing. All right. Now, Luke on 27, Laura 22. Luke, your letters again.
Can I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, Luke. R.
And another.
T.
And a vowel, please.
I.
And another.
O.
And another.
E.
And a consonant, please.
L.
And another.
G.
And another.
T.
And a final vowel, please.
And a final O.
Stand by. Yes, Luke.
A five.
A five, Laura.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Right, Luke.
Gloat.
Gloat, Laura.
Glitter.
And glitter.
Glitter is excellent. There's no A for gloat though.
Oh, I spelt it with just an L.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Yeah.
So glitter
very,
wins.
Very good. Yeah.
Indeed, Susanna, Susie.
Yeah, so we'd only got to a six and we'd just gone scatological. Litter, toilet, that's where we were. We didn't lift up to our eyes to glitter.
No. To glitter. All right. Glitter does you a lot of good, actually. Propels you to 2 points in the lead, 29 to Luke's 27. And it's your letters game now. Yes, Laura?
May I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, Laura.
S.
Another?
D.
Another one?
N.
A vowel?
A.
Another vowel?
E.
Another consonant?
S.
Another consonant?
L.
A vowel, please?
A.
And one more consonant, please.
And the last one. P.
And the clock starts now. Six and Luke.
Six.
Laura?
Past.
Yes, Luke.
Slains.
Slains?
Yeah.
No, not with that spelling.
No.
Just to have slain somebody's S-L-A-I-N. But there's no noun like that, I'm afraid. Sorry.
Okay. Bad luck. What can we have in the corner? Susie? And Susanna?
Sandals.
Sandals?
Yes.
Very good. Sandals, all right. 35 now plays 27, and we go into numbers. Yes, Luke?
Could I have two from the top and then four little ones, please?
You can indeed. Thank you, Luke. Two large, four small, and the four smalls this time. Seven, five, 10, and two, and the large, 75 and 100. And the target, 501.
501. Yes, Luke?
502.
And Laura?
501.
Laura?
So the 100 times 5?
500.
And then 10 minus 7 minus 2 is the 1?
Is the 1.
And add the 2 to go.
Yeah.
There we go.
Well done.
Well done. Well done. Increases your lead 45 now to Luke's 27 as we go into our second tea time teaser, which is start game. And the clue, before the start of the game, you'll probably want to have a plan in place. Before the start of the game, you'll probably want to have a plan in place. Welcome back. I left with the clue. Before the start of the game, you'll probably want to have a plan in place. You'll probably have a stratagem. A stratagem. So 45 plays 27. Laura in the lead. Laura, your letters game.
May I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thank you, Laura.
S. And another?
H.
A vowel, please?
E.
Another vowel?
I.
Consonant, please.
D.
Another consonant?
L.
Another?
S.
A vowel?
E.
And another consonant, please.
And lastly, T.
And the clock starts now. Yes, Laura.
A 7.
A 7.
Luke? And a 7 as well.
Laura.
Shields.
And?
Shields.
Two shields, just show Laura.
That's all there.
Yeah. There we go. Any more 7s, I wonder? Susanna?
No, we all saw that coming out, didn't we? But no more 7s.
No, desist for 6.
Thank you, Laura. Well done. So 52 to 34, and it's Luke. Luke's letters game.
Can I have a consonant, Rachel, please?
Thank you, Luke. V.
And another?
L.
And another?
R.
And a vowel, please?
A.
And another?
I.
And another?
O.
And a consonant, please?
T.
And another?
D.
And another, please?
And lastly, R.
Stand by. Yes, Luke.
An 8.
An 8, Laura.
7.
That 7 mm-hmm. is?
Trailer.
Trailer. Luke?
Radiator.
Radiator.
OK, no E for trailer. I don't think we can get radiator out of here either, I'm afraid. I have to disallow both. I'm sorry.
So hard.
I'm sorry.
What can you have? Susanna?
Dilator.
A dilator, yep. Yes. Anything else?
Like a dilator muscle. The pupil of your eye is a dilator muscle.
All right. 52 to 34. And Susie, you're back on with your origins of words. And today?
Well, I told Susanna I was going to be talking doublets, and she got quite excited because I think she thought I was going to talk about the costume, doublets in that sense. But no, I'm going to talk about doublets in language, which are words that go back to the same root, the same etymological source, if you like, but they look quite different because they were borrowed into English at different times. And English is this great hoover that just absorbs words and has done for centuries. So the English too and duo are doublets. One comes from a Germanic source. Twa was the Germanic root of two, which gave us twain, of course, as well. And duo came straight from Latin. Fresh and fresco are also doublets. Fresco, of course, referred to fresh plaster. We borrowed those in at different times. But a doublet doesn't just have to mean two when it comes to language. Sometimes so many different words are borrowed at different times and they all go back to the same root. So oaf and elf are actually related because the elves, a bit like the fairies, were very fond of human children and they liked to play all sorts of games and mischief on them. But sometimes it got a bit more sinister because they fell into the habit of stealing perfect children from their homes and replacing them, so it was thought, with changelings. So those who were considered inferior or deficient in some way, very cruel, so possibly consider them to be less than clever, for example. And the changeling was called an oaf. That goes back to an Old Norse word, actually a Viking word, for elf, because the elves had left this changeling there. And over time, the idea of a simple child was then attached to a simple person, a simpleton, a fool, and we ended up with a clumsy oaf that we have today. But oaf and elf are perfect doublets in English.
Wow. It's a very chilling story,
isn't
it?
I know, it's not nice.
Very chilling. Horrid. It's 52, page 34. Laura's in the lead. Laura, you're back with the letters game.
May I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, Laura.
L.
Another?
F.
Another?
C.
A vowel, please?
E.
Another vowel?
U.
Another vowel?
O.
A consonant?
S.
Another consonant?
N.
And one more consonant, please.
And the last one, F.
Countdown. A six and?
And a five.
And your five?
Fuels.
Thank you, Laura.
Clones.
Clones, yeah.
Absolutely fine.
Any advance?
We had a flounces for eight.
Oh, well done.
And a couple of sevens.
Good word, yes. Confuse and scuffle. Both there for seven.
Scuffle. And flounce, yeah, to flounce. Flounced out. 58, please, 34. And Luke, final letters game for you.
Can I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, Luke.
N.
And another?
T.
And a vowel, please?
E.
And another?
A.
And another?
E.
And a consonant, please?
H.
And another?
D.
And another?
N.
And a final vowel, please?
And a final I.
Stand by. Yes, Luke?
I'll try a six.
A six. And Laura?
Seven.
And a seven. Yes, Luke?
Heiden.
No, Laura Marsh.
Find.
So how are you spelling Heiden?
H-E-A-D-E-N.
No.
Not
there, I'm afraid. I'm sorry, Luke. Sorry. And?
Find.
Find. It's absolutely fine, yes. No problem with that.
Well done.
Yeah.
Any advances, Susanna?
Only a seven, net head.
Thank you. Anything else, Susie?
No, that is a habitual and expert user of the internet. That's a
note. Thank you. All right. So 65 pace, 34 into the final numbers game, and it's got Laura's name on it. Laura.
Okay. May I have two from the top and any other four this
you
time?
You may. Thank you, Laura. Two large, four little, and the final one of the day is 4, 10, 5, 3, and then the big ones, 50 and 25. And this target, 747.
747. Yes, Laura.
747.
And Luke.
740.
740. So Laura, let's try you.
Okay, so 5 plus the 10, 15.
5 plus 10, 15.
Times the 50.
750.
Minus the 3.
747.
There we are. Well done. Well done, Laura. Good score, 75. Luke on 34, not bad as we go into the final round. Fingers on buzzers. Let's roll today's countdown conundrum. We're foxed up here. Who in the audience? Yes, sir.
Fruitiest.
Fruitiest. Let's see whether you're right. Fruitiest. Well done. Well done. Fruitiest, indeed. So, Laura, 75 to Luke, sir. 34. Well played, Luke. Well played. But today's not your day. And so it's back to Staffordshire, back to Leek. With your goodie bag and our very best wishes. And thank you very much for coming.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for coming. All right. We shall see you, Laura, from Rorton, tomorrow. Well done.
Thank you.
Congratulations. All right. And we shall see Susanna and Susie tomorrow also.
See you then.
Thanks for that terrifying story.
I'm full of them.
More tomorrow. All right. See you tomorrow.
Yeah, go and hug a spider if you see one in the meantime.
Hug may be the wrong word.
Nothing to worry. Give it a little stroke.
Yeah, push it down to the window, I think. All right. See you tomorrow.
See you then.
Same time.